Now here we are to have a look at a Bowlback guitar, an innovation copy. This one is issued under the gear4music label, and as you can see, a shallow bowl electric guitar with a pickup in it. It's got a preamp, a four band preamp there, and what we're hearing now is just coming through the microphone. And as you can hear there, it's pretty much in tune all the way up the neck of the guitar. Now, if I give it a wee bit of welly with a plectrum, there you go. Now, in common with a lot of these Bowlback guitars, the action is quite low. Now that's because they're basically aimed at the electric guitarist who wants to take up the acoustic guitar. So you have a low action. Now that has obvious advantages. It's more comfortable to play. But with a plectrum, if you're giving it a little welly, if you're trying to produce a lot of volume, you might well end up with some rattling and buzzing of the strings. The neck in this, I checked it with a steel rule, it's 100% straight. You might think, oh great, well yeah, it's okay, but actually a slight amount of relief in the middle of the neck, a slight dip, usually about the thickness of whatever plectrum you use. You can use the plectrum as a feeler gauge between the string and the top of the fret. Is usually what we want, but if you do want a really low action, then yeah, a straight neck is the thing that's called for. Now, construction wise, you have a decent set of machine heads, the nut's well adjusted, it's right down as low as it could possibly go, which is good. You've got a compensated saddle here. The finish is high gloss on the front of the guitar and a satin finish on the neck, which is much nicer than gloss. You can actually slide your hand up a lot quicker on a satin neck than you can on a gloss neck. It's kind of counterintuitive, but that's the way it works. Now, we've got a pickup in it, so what I'll do now is I'll turn the mic down. So what you're going to hear now, what you've been hearing now is a combination of mic and pickup. Well, no, it's not, I tell a lie. That was just the mic. Turn the volume up on the pickup. Turn the mic down. So there you go, that is the pickup, and lastly, pickup and mic together. Now, as you can tell from the clean shirt, a few days have elapsed and there have been one or two changes to the guitar. Many of these guitars, which are budget guitars, are obviously rather tinny sounding instruments. when you compare it to something that might be 10 times the price, it's not surprising. But what you can do about that is you can change the strings on the guitar. And what I've done here is I've put on a set of Bowlback nylon strings on it, Martin Bowlback nylon strings. Now, that reduces the tension. Let's have a listen to it. We're just through the microphone at the moment. And as you can hear, there's a rather lute-like sound coming out of the beast now. What I did have to do is I had to put in a higher saddle, otherwise there would be fret buzz all over the place. So a higher saddle, but that was the only absolutely essential modification to the guitar. I did, however, take the opportunity to change the undersaddle transducer. This guitar's fitted with the rather what is now old style transducers, which are a small metal trough with a black rubber coating on them round the crystals. But the more modern type look like a wee earthworm, and the cable type they're called, and they actually give a better balanced output from the strings than the older ones do. On the original pickup, the fourth string was very quiet, and that's not just this guitar that applies to, but basically anything with that style of pickup. If you put nylon strings on, the fourth string will be a wee bit quiet. If you're just strumming and doing the kind of Corey's folk music sort of thing, you wouldn't notice it. But if you're doing the classical stuff, you really need to change that as well. But they're not expensive, so, and very easy to fit. You just unplug the original one, pull it out, plug in the new one. No drilling of holes or anything nasty like that. So, what does it sound like? We've had a little bit on straight acoustic. Now let's put the microphone off and bring up the pickup. Now you'll notice that I'm playing with a capo on. If you're used to nylon string guitars, you're probably used to a slightly wider neck, and by putting the capo on, you get that. The necks are tapered, so the higher up the neck it goes, the wider your fingerboard suddenly appears to be. And what you're hearing there, that was the pickup and the microphone together. Should you choose to put ordinary nylon strings on it, not the ball end, but the tie-on ones, you will have to do one thing. These guitars, anything that's got the ovation style bridge, the back edge is rather sharp, so you might need to take a wee bit of sandpaper or a wee bit of a file and just round off that edge, otherwise you're likely to end up with the string breakages there. But there's no reason why you can't use tie-on nylons as well. And you end up with a hybrid guitar, which is about half the price of the cheapest custom-made one on the market. They tend to start about £150 or so, and you're getting this for maybe about £80 all in. So there you go. Food for thought.